And thank you, William Tonks, for accompanying. Terrific.
Thank you, William.
Let's hear it for William. Great job.
It's a pretty song I want to play. Speaking of pretty songs, I determined when I turned 30, because, you know, Athens has kind of a reputation, punk rock town, you know, it's an angry place, barbecue killers, Mercy Land, there's some aggressive stuff going on. Sons of Orion, there's a lot of aggression, a lot of fun music, a lot of cool stuff. But I decided that when, at some point in time, I said, if you really want to be punk rock in a punk rock town, write a pretty song. That's being nervy. I caught some serious flack. Pretty songs.
When was this?
So this is one of the first pretty songs that were, okay, you might not think it's pretty. I think it's pretty. Anyway, people make fun. But I still like it. Slept, I lay down on the couch. Okay, it's a pretty song.
It is pretty. And what you didn't tell us the name of it.
Yeah, punk. It's
Homecoming.
What is it called?
Coming Home, Homecoming.
Theme running through the night. I don't remember what the title of that song is.
Okay. I liked it. Just asking, well, your guitar is so much different than everybody else's here. Tell us a little bit about it.
It's from the Island of Misfit Guitars. seasonal, come on. It is actually a Rosanophonic guitar. So it is technically a guitar, but just like people call all clear adhesive tape Scotch tape, people call all Rosanophonic guitars Dobros, because that is the first kind of name that they got from the Dobro company.
How many guitars do you own? I'm curious.
Less than 15.
Less than 15?
Yeah.
Oh, so 14. Yeah. Scott, how many do you own?
More than 200.
But a lot of those are for sale, correct?
They're like children, you can't sell them, you know? Love it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. William Thomas. Homecoming.